Well, it feels comforting in here.
So good. I'm hoping I can get moved in pretty quick and all this can be done. And everyone can go back to their normal lives before there's any more fighting or anyone else gets upset.
Why did we even need this? I don't know, man. You know what I mean?
She wanted to bring it.
Because when it happens, it makes me feel just like I did when I was a kid, where my mom and dad argued. And all I could do to handle the fear and pain was eat. So this has been really hard.
Yeah, go ahead and start making the swing.
Careful.
Be careful.
Right here.
Right here?
Yep.
I'm gonna put my hand down.
There's gonna be a big couch.
Walk it up.
Made it all the way down here without even a scratch. Awesome. 2 more minutes, I'll be ready to go again.
All right.
Boxes.
There you go. What's Otter doing?
Sitting on his butt.
Oh, geez. Are you gonna help or what?
You want me to help you in my hospital bed?
Closet. Dad, stop. Chad.
What?
Don't set him off.
It's too hot out there. He gets hot-headed anyway.
Hey! Here, let me get that.
Get out of my way.
Oh. Stop! Right now!
And you stop it.
You need to calm down.
You need to calm down.
You calm down right now.
Tell me something like that.
I got the next bag, honey.
I don't know what got into him, but all of a sudden he's...
I'm so thankful my dad's helping me do this, but I'm not gonna lie. When he is mad, it makes it really hard to do what I'm supposed to. I have solved all of our eating issues.
I'll do chicken. I'll do any kind of chicken.
All right, I'll get that.
Cool.
This all has created a lot of fear and doubt about whether I'm gonna be able to do this at all. Because experiencing all this anxiety and fear with everyone fighting has made me realize how much food helps me to manage and deal with all that when it happens.
Just set it in, down. Down anywheres.
The food's here, guys. There's chicken. More chicken.
Wow.
Uh-huh.
Oh, yeah.
So help yourselves. I want to get my life back, but I'm terrified that I can't and that I'm not ready for surgery because it's gonna take away something I need and that's really important to me. And if I have to give up food, I'll get to a point where I just won't be able to deal with things. And if that happens, I don't know what I'll do. It could be really bad. So moving ahead may end up being one of the biggest mistakes I've ever made. After we got all my stuff moved in here and I got situated, my dad and my brother headed back home. I called Dr. No and told him about how I'm struggling with having second thoughts about weight loss surgery and how my family fighting and all the stress of that made me wonder if I could truly give up what has helped me cope my whole life. So he said that he's canceling the surgery and he wants me to go see a psychotherapist before we decide to do anything else. But my mom is really upset because she feels like I'm risking my only chance to do this. And she's also worried if I go to therapy that they'll find out that I suffer from bipolar disorder. And she thinks that could ruin my chances to get surgery. So she wants me to avoid telling them if I go, but I'm not gonna lie.
All right, so what are we gonna do about this problem?
I don't wanna talk about it.
Now don't go run into your room. You do that every time. Lacey, I'm not letting this go, so you better come out here and discuss this with me. Come on, Lacey.
Leave me alone.
Fine, I'll leave you alone, Lacey. For a while. And you have to rethink this. Dr. Nazarden.
The second is Houston 2 on Herman Park Drive.
Hey, Siri.
Why are you even bothering calling?
I need Dr. Nazarden's office, please.
You're not calling them.
One possibility is nose home remodeling.
You don't tell me what to do.
There's no reason to. I've already talked to them.
I haven't.
You don't need to. I already told you what they said.
You're not listening to me. Speak with him. I need to speak with him.
He's not the one you talk to.
You never share anything with me.
You are not listening to what I'm saying.
I need to know if you have to get this resolved before you move on with your surgery. And if so,
I
need to know how long it's going to be. Because I am not going to stay in this hell more than a year.
What else do you want me to do? I just need to go to a psychologist, Mom.
I want you to not go to your room and act like a baby.
I'm not.
And I need to know about.
I tell you, you don't
you
hear
don't
me.
Don't share with me.
I tell you
only
everything.
Only when I need to know, you tell me.
No, you don't listen to me. You don't hear me. You're not hearing me right now. You don't hear
go,
me right now.
Go make yourself some lunch and
no,
leave me alone.
You're not hearing me.
I call myself.
Still not hearing me. I wish my mom would just leave me alone. She can't just give me the space I need to work through this. I know I'm gonna get to a point where I just can't take it. And I'm gonna end up either quitting the whole program altogether or just end up giving in to my cravings and just eat everything I want. And if I let either of those happen, it'll really mean I lost my chance to get weight loss surgery. And I'll end up right back where I was before I started all of this. So I'm really scared right now because I'm close to letting that happen.